Hi everybody, this is Gijs again with another review and I hope you are doing well. This time it is a stove, the Primus Fire Stick. And in this review I will tell you all the pros and the cons of this little stove. Enjoy the review! Welcome to the review of the Primus Fire Stick stove. For those of you who are following me already for some while, I would like to say welcome back to my channel. For those of you who are new to my channel, I would like to explain that I am a 100% independent reviewer, so manufacturers are not paying me for my reviews. If you like this video after seeing it, then please subscribe to my YouTube channel and also don't forget to hit the alarm bell so you know when I uploaded a new video, because more subscribers means that I can make more videos on a regular basis. So with your support, I am able to do this. So many thanks in advance already. And now let's start with the review of the Fire Stick itself. Now you see, I've got everything displayed here. And first, what I always like to do is just go through the numbers. The package without, of course, the canister, I measured it on my precise scale and the total package weighs 134.1 grams. The stove itself, including this little cap that goes on top there, weighs 104.3 grams and it's a little bit lighter than the 105 grams that Primus claims. Now the piezo itself, which is basically the igniter for those of you who don't know this, it weighs 15.7 grams and the pouch, which is made out of wool, weighs 14 grams. The pack size is 103 millimeters in basically height and 36 millimeters in width. But then, of course, when you put the legs together, this is how you get the smallest size. Now, the stove, Primus claims a power output of 2500 watts, which is quite a decent amount of power for such a small burner. Now, before I crack on with the Primus review itself, I would like you to take a small adventure with me. Maybe you've seen it behind me. There is a whole bunch of stoves on my little bench. And I would like to explain a little bit about the stoves that I personally own and how I look from that experience with those stoves to the Primus Fire Stick. So follow me over to this side. The first one is the Primus EtaPower. It's a piezo operated one. It's fixed to the burner itself and it's got a pot with a heat exchanger. More on this later. Then I have a Primus, which I don't know what the name is because I couldn't find it online anymore. The Primus PrimeTech, which is basically the follow-up of the EtaPower, also with a separate piezo and a heat exchanger. Well, then the Primus Express Spider, which is a nice one as well, and the famous MSR XJK Expedition stove that basically runs on kerosene and that kind of fuels. Next is the Jetboil, a very easy burner stove with also a fixed piezo. Also famous is the MSR Whisperlite, and I think this is the international one. This is my previous one. This one has been burned and scorched. I'm not using this one anymore. From the Whisperlites, we continue to a classic Trangia, also a pot system, cooking system, and a classic Primus. Now, one of my all-time favorites is the Optimus Crux, a very little nifty stove. And two other classics are, of course, the Campinggas Bleuet 206 and the Coleman Feather. Nice to have the Avenue Titanium. It's a alcohol burner, like the cola canister that is turned into an alcohol burner. And now we turn back to the Fire Stick from Primus. So that was a very quick run through on the stoves that I normally use. And to be honest, I'm still very, very fond of my Primus EtaPower. It's such a shame that they don't make it anymore because it's really a wonderful cooking system. Now, let me get back to the Fire Stick. And what I should demonstrate is basically how to operate it. And then I will take it off from the canister. What you should know, the stove fits on every canister, of course. The big ones, the small ones. If you go camping in the winter times, it's a very good idea to bring a green one from Primus, a brown one from Primus, because that's a special winter gas that will perform better when it's really cold. Now, let me put it together. When you buy the Primus, this is what you get. A nice little pouch with the stuff in there. As I mentioned before, it is made out of wool. And because it's made out of wool, when I put it aside into the nature, then you can see that all stingy stuff is sticking to it. In that respect, wool is not that, well, in my opinion, not that clever. So let me get rid of that. And on the back, there's also stingy stuff. But wool, it's got a nice feel to it. So in that respect, it's quite okay. But you can hear the sound. It's not totally wrapping around the stove itself, so it will still make a lot of noise in your backpack if it's not packed tight. Now, the pouch itself, it's like an envelope. And like an envelope, it's got two openings on this side. Now, what happened to me quite a few times is that when I put this in my backpack, then you can see already that the piezo is departing from basically the envelope. I would rather have seen a nice little pocket made out of a material that doesn't stick for plants and that kind of stuff, just with a little a pulling tab so that it closes neatly. Now, that said, what Primus also said, and that's quite neat and I can't check it basically, is that this is also, you can use this also as a sort of isolation bucket for a pot. Well, sorry, I don't have a pot that is this size. And I think it's more like, okay, they came up with another feature which I don't think that anybody will ever use, but you know, they thought about this. But I don't think that the pouch is that good. Now, the function of the fire stick itself, it's a very easy one. Take the cap off, it's a twist cap, because if you twist it, it holds, it stays on the top. If you don't twist it, it will fall off again. And you see that by little springs, the arms, they open quite neatly. Now, then it's a matter of screwing it on there, which is not too hard. It doesn't take too many turns. What you should know is now that this one is empty, just because of I'm doing this demonstration here. But I will show you some real fire later. Now, what I do like about the Primus is the fact that the turning knob, it takes basically two full cycles from closed to fully open. And what I also discovered is that it is very well fine-tunable. So if you like to simmer for a longer time a dish, that is absolutely possible with this one. But normally when I take my lightweight stuff with me, then I don't want to simmer. I just want to have a quick meal and I just put it on full power. Now, the design of this one, and there's a video on my channel as well with an interview with the designer of Primus. And he's explained me that basically the shape of the legs, you know, you've seen them behind me. Most of them, they are very narrow, the pot holders. But these are very wide. And the reason for this is that they designed this one to give a amount of wind protection. But the pot support, it is not that great, to be honest. Because yes, it gives maybe wind protection, but above here there are, and you will see that there are still gaps, so the wind will blow through this. And of course, between the legs itself, the gap is also always bigger than the legs are protecting the flame. So in that respect, I'm not sure if this is mission accomplished. What I also found in comparison with all the other ones that I have, and also with the small ones, is that if I put a pot on here, that the pot supports are not that great either. And maybe I should demonstrate this. Let me get a pot. And this is quite something that I don't like, because now I have a pot on my stove, on the fire stick. And if you take a very close look, then you can see that the pot support basically supports the pan with this very flat surface, not with the nice teeth that are on here. They don't grip the pen. And what happens is that it moves around very easily. Now, this is a titanium pot and there's no liquid in here, so that makes it a little bit easy, but I'll put some pressure on it. And you see, it's still not that great because it's not on the teeth of the pot supports itself. I've been using this one with quite a lot of different pots, and the ones that work really well, to be honest, are the ones from Primus themselves with the heat exchanger around it. And now I'm talking about the heat exchanger, let me go into the boiling times. Because I measured, of course, the boiling times of 1 liter of water. And I've done this here inside. And now let's move over to how I did it. What I always do, I start with measuring the amount of water. 1 liter is weighted on a scale. And when I have a little bit too much, I take a straw and I fine tune the weight till I have exactly 1000 grams, because 1 liter weighs 1 kilo. Now that's how you do it. It's a matter of being precise. And that's also what I do with the canister and the stove. I weighed it so I can measure the amount of gas that I'm using to boil 1 liter of water. Now, then I use a lighter, because a lighter is better than a piezo because it's more direct. And of course, I start the stopwatch on the iPhone. Now, what I always like to do is just to see also how the flame is putting the heat into a pan. And this is a normal pan. And then you can see that with the normal pan and the burner at full power, that basically the flames are licking around the pot itself. So it's not that efficient. I did the same for the pot from Primus with the heat exchanger, because I really wanted to know if there is a difference in boiling time. And also I did have a look at the flames, and you can see that they are not licking aside the pot, so this is way more efficient. Then I wait till the water comes to a rolling boil and I measure the time. I stop the stopwatch. And the last thing I do is just measure the canister again with the stove to see how much gas it has used. Now the results, and I must state that I did this test several times, so the numbers that I give are averages. And I measured at room temperature, which was 20 degrees, and a water temperature of 20 degrees as well. Now the boiling time with the regular normal pot was 4 minutes and 45 seconds, and it takes 12.8 grams of gas. Now, with the pot with the heat exchanger, it was way faster and way more efficient, because I measured a boiling time of 3 minutes and 25 seconds, and it uses only 9.4 grams of gas. So that means it is way faster and it takes less gas, which is of course pretty logical. Now, the number that Primus claims on the boiling time is 3 minutes and 30 seconds. Now, I don't really know how they measure this, but I think it's quite optimistic, to be honest, if you use a regular pot. Now, this was of course the testing that I did indoors, which is quite sort of scientific and repetitive. So I can measure this and compare it to other stoves that I did. Now, indoors, in this kind of circumstances, the Primus stove is quite nice on a average stove. The numbers are not that bad. But when you go outdoors, the numbers are basically a lot worse, because I measure times that don't even get near the boiling time that I measured indoors. And I'm not going to name the number, because the conditions, they vary a lot. But really, it is not that windproof, and a lot of heat is being blown away from the pots basically. My advice would be, so if you use it outdoors, use a pot with a heat exchanger. Now, let's get back to the functionality of the Fire Stick itself. Yes, I do like the design, I like the folding mechanism, I like the way that it's very easy to turn, but I don't like the piezo. Not only because you can lose it in your backpack, and even when you're outdoors, this is a thing that you will lose in the end if you're not very careful. But what I noticed is that if I have a pot on here and I put the piezo between it and I turn the gas on, it is very hard to ignite the gas itself. It works way better if you take the pot off and you do it from above, then it's quite easy. But to be honest, the piezo as a separate thing, if you lose it, well, basically you're screwed, because you can't light your fire anymore. So you will have to have a backup anyway. And I would advise everybody, if you use something like this, always have a backup system. Unless you have a piezo, of course, attached to the burner. But now let me get what I normally do. I always carry one of these with me. And this is it's just a lighter with a very fierce power flame. This is basically the best way to ignite any stove, in my opinion. So I'm not too keen on this one. The other thing that I'm not too keen on is basically on this little cap that is on top of the pot supports, because it is quite fiddly to put on. And what happened to me a couple of weeks ago is that I was out camping, and I took this one off, I did my meal, it was dark, and I put this one probably somewhere in the grass, or maybe, because it was very, very windy, it has been blown away from where I was camping. But at least the following day, I could not find it anymore. So I took a little bit of Elastiband around this one, put it back in the pouch into my backpack. That worked fine. The next days, I thought it can't be lost forever. So I went back to the place where I went and I found this one again. But basically, this is a stove with two functionality problems. First is this one, and the worst one is this one, because without this one, you won't do anything. And that is why I like normal, regular stoves that have not got the option of something like this, unless when it's really attached, like the ETA Power and like the Yetboil. But if you have a normal stove, and I'll grab them, if you have one like the Crux, or you take the old one from Primus, then you don't have the idea that you have the whole set complete. You always have to have the awareness that you take something with you to lighten the stuff. Now, if we are talking about size, yes, I do think this is quite small. It's sort of lightweight. But now let me demonstrate this one. This one folds back, and the pot supports, to be honest, they are absolutely great. And then you do it like this, you twist it, fold it, and basically this is the whole package that you get. So in this respect, is the Fire Stick really small? No, I don't think so. Is this one foolproof? Yes, it is. Is that one foolproof? Yes, it is. And this one is definitely not foolproof. Now it's time to head on to my verdict. You might get the idea already by now. I'm not too positive on the Primus Fire Stick stove. In the first place, because I think it is not windproof enough, like what Primus basically promises. I don't like the fact that you can lose the metal cap quite easily. I don't like the fact that the piezo is not attached to the system itself, so you can lose this one as well. Next to that, it does not always work 100% okay. I like the fact that the pouch is made out of wool, but please make a pouch without the possibility that stuff can get out. I don't need a pouch to isolate my beverages or my drinks, because then I have an isolated cup anyway. So that's not necessary. Make a decent pouch. And the boiling time of 4 minutes and 45 seconds for a small stove with 2500 watts. It's not absolutely good, it's not bad either, but it's not on the number that basically Primus promises, the 3 minutes and 30 seconds. And now the price. The Primus Fire Stick retails for, and hold on to your seat, €89.95. Now, this is the metal one. There's also a titanium one, which is a few grams lighter, and that one retails for €119.95. And both numbers, the price, I think it's way too high for the product that you basically get with all the flaws that it has. And therefore, I rate the Primus Fire Stick, regrettably, at only 6.3 points out of 10 total. Sorry. I hope you liked the review and that it was useful to you. And if it was, please give it a like and leave a comment below. And I'm very curious to know if you agree on my opinion on the Primus Fire Stick. So please use the comment section. And please, if you disagree with me, let me know, because I'm really, really curious. Now, if this is the first time that you watched the video of me and you liked it, then please like the video and also subscribe to my channel. And don't forget to hit the alarm bell so you know when I uploaded a new video, because this really, really helps. And if you do, many, many thanks in advance. And if you like this video, then please continue watching, because there are so many more interesting videos on my channel. You might have seen the backpack over there. It is the Fjällräven Shinji 48. I reviewed that one as well, and I'll put the link up here. If you're curious about tents, I just released a review on the Hilleberg Anaris, which is a very nice rich tent for two persons. So please continue watching. And if you're done watching for today, then please enjoy the outdoors and stay safe. Ciao, ciao.